Oh, wow. Well, hello there. Good afternoon, everybody. I didn't see you there, but here we are now. My name is Mr. Villanueva, and I am the music teacher at Orange Grove Elementary School here at Anaheim Elementary, the school district. Anyways, so here we are. Welcome to our stream, AESD at Home. And here we are. You can even see that when I'm not teaching music at Orange Grove, I play some music outside as a saxophonist. I've traveled across the world as a saxophonist, and I've been really happy to do that, obviously prior to our current world situation. But here we are. So this instrument I was just playing at the top is what we call a melodica. And this is basically a piano that doesn't require any electricity, just your air and a tube to, you know, transfer your the air from to the reeds inside the melodica and make a sound. So I'll play a little bit more of the melodica so you can just see how this works. And you can also even play familiar music such as this. Yeah, so you can do something solid, silly as that, or you can do something a bit more serious like this. Yeah, so whatever you can play on the piano with one hand, mainly your right hand, you can play on the melodica. And you can even also do some really cool things like this, too. And for all our music theorist friends, I was playing in fourths. Wow. So let's talk about the parts of the melodica, shall we? So here we have the keyboard itself. Modeled as same thing as a piano, we have a series of white keys and a series of black keys. Wow! So if you play piano already, playing the melodica is a pretty easy transition. But notice, if I push on the keys by themselves without blowing any air to it, all we get is just key noise. So you can even see it right over here on the tiny camera. I'm pushing all these buttons, but sadness and despair, there's no sound coming out of them. But that's why we have something called the tube mouthpiece right over here, which will connect the melodica. And then finally, you put the tube mouthpiece right here into your mouth, and you articulate two or blow air, and you finally get some sound. But if I just blow air without pressing any keys, there's no sound. What's wrong? Is the melodica broken? Well, the thing is, you have to push on a key, kind of like a piano, so that you make sound. Check this out. And the cool thing about a melodica, as opposed to playing a real piano, is you can do what we call articulations with your tongue, so you can do stuff like this. Okay, now I'm just playing around. And if you notice on my right side over here, there is a mouthpiece. There's this missing part here called just a mouthpiece by itself. I don't play that typically because it won't allow me to stretch as far. But if you had the mouthpiece, you would have the melodica over here and play it this way. So those are some options. And the best thing of all is that melodicas are cheap. So if you ever wanted to learn how to start playing the keyboard instrument, you can start with this. They're relatively cheap on Amazon. For around like $22, you can get yourself a working melodica for you, your students, or your child. Or if you are the child, you can get one for yourself. As a matter of fact, students at Orange Grove Elementary, some of my students back there have their own melodicas, and we are one of the two schools in the Anaheim Elementary School District that has a class set of melodicas. Obviously, we can't use them right now due to world circumstances, but prior to the pandemic, we had a class set of these for our students at Orange Grove to use. Nowadays, Mann Elementary got a set of melodicas thanks to the NAM Foundation. So welcome, Mann, to the melodica group. Hopefully other AESD schools can join us in the melodica gang in the future. So we're going to transition over to some body drumming. So for those of us that don't have instruments at home, here's a way that we can participate in music if we don't have any instruments. So I created this icon. These icons over here. So on my left, right over here, we have our knees. So you raise your hand up and tap your knees. And right over with where the hands are, you clap your hands. Where the shoes are, you stomp your feet with your right foot and your left foot, depending on the R and the L, and you snap your fingers with right and left. This symbol right over here, if I can just appear on screen for a second. Very good. This symbol right over here, I'm not gonna move that. So this symbol right here is what we call a quarter rest in music, and basically it's just a symbol for silence. So in this situation, we'll probably just either just move silently or you know, just kind of not make any audible sounds with our bodies. But how do we apply this? So let's take a look at this video right over here with Meghan Trainor's Better When I Am Dancing. Hey, come on. Yeah, let's do it. Knees clap.
Don't think
knees
clap. About it. Just move your body. Listen to the
follow
music.
The pictures.
Sing, oh, yeah, oh.
And tap your knees
just
and clap your hands. Come on.
Go ahead, hey. Crazy. Anyone can do it. Sing, oh, yeah, oh.
And now it's right. Stomp, 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 snap, snap, stomp, stomp, snap, snap. Let's do it. Come on. Hey.
Show the room what you
yeah.
Can do. Prove to them you got the moves.
Stomp, stomp, snap, snap.
Stop, I feel snap, better snap. When I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah.
Clap, clap,
better
clap.
When I'm
come
dancing.
On.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey!
And we can do this together. I bet you feel better when you're dancing. Yeah, yeah.
And over here, we're not told to do anything with our bodies, so just dance. Relax. Here we go. Back to the knees and hands patterns for the verses. Oh, oh, hey.
You're
hey.
Yeah, you make your
and for the pre-chorus, you switch over. Stomp, stomp, snap, snap. Stomp, stomp, snap, snap. Stomp, stomp, snap, snap. Stomp, stomp, snap, snap. Right, left, 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 right, left. Rest, snap. Again, these symbols that you over here are symbols of silence. Although I am talking right now, but as a demonstration. Stomp, stomp, snap, snap. 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 Now you're grooving.
We can do this together. Bet you feel better when you're dancing.
Here we go. And now let's groove. Groove and groove and groove and groove and groove and groove and groove. Groove, groove. Woo. And here we go. Snap, 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 snap. Yeah, so that's one active way that we can create music at home or participate in music by using our bodies. Our bodies are instruments, and you can get this for free 99. Okay, no, I'm joking. All right, let's move forward. So we're here. Oopsies, sorry about that. So In addition to body percussion, for those of you that wish to play drum set, but unfortunately don't have a drum set for some reason, you can use your body as a drum set. So let's take a look at a past version of me when I used to have hair and how he demonstrates the introductions to body drumming in the style of a drum set.
All right, so.
Oopsies. Technical difficulties. Let's rewind and press play. Very good, yes.
All right, so we established our right foot kick and our left hand snare we hit with our belly. So now let's combine these two appendages together in this manner. Foot, hand, kick, snare. Foot, hand, kick, snare. So you're gonna stomp on your foot first, or tap, excuse me. Then you're gonna use your left hand to tap your belly like this. This is what we call the kick snare pattern. Kick, snare. And to align this, what we talked about earlier in terms of counting, this is how it goes. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And can you do this with me? 1, 2, let's go. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And keep it going with the foot and hand. Foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand. Let's end it here right now. Very good. Moving on to the next step.
Cool. So, as Mr. Villanueva with hair said, so you can use your foot and your belly. Ooh, gotta be careful over there. So, use your foot and hand to create what we call the backbeat, but just using our what we call the kick and snare, we're going foot, hand. But let's apply this to actual music. To celebrate the end of the month of September, I figured we might as well just play this song and feel the groove. So first feel it. So you can hear that that cowbell in the butt, and that'll be your tempo. Here we go, and I'll guide you through this. Foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand. Stop, 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 tap, stop, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand. And if you wanted to get fancy, here's a piece in the next step. 1, 2, 3, 4, where you add our shoulders to the beat. Woo! Hey! And then I can show you where we're headed next after this. Check it out, let's go. 's hard to go wrong with Earth, Wind, and Fire. Very awesome music. So, but now, as I teased in the Earth, Wind, and Fire example, you can also use two hands in the mix. I will let Mr. Villanueva, or a younger version of me, demonstrate this.
When you do body drumming, it can get a little confusing at times when you use three limbs at a time. So let's break it down to just two limbs. But instead of just using our kick, snare, let's instead incorporate just two hands. Your left hand on your belly right over here, and your right hand on your shoulder, on your opposite shoulder like this, okay? So we're gonna go like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and 1 hand, 2 hands, 1 hand, 2 hands, 1 hand, 2 hands, 1 hand, 2 hands. Kind of like that, right? But when you count, it's gonna go like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 1 and 2 and three, and four, and. Okay? Try that with me. One, and two. Simplify it. Go. One, and two, and three, and four, and. One, and two, and three, and four. Again. One, and two, and three, and four. One more time. One, and two, and three, and four. So now, let's escalate the activity like this. One, and two, and three, and four. And one, and two, and three, and four. And one, and two, and three, and four. And one, and two, and three, and four. And
cool, cool, cool. So, let's practice this in the context of music. We're going to do something a little bit slower because I know There were moments where I stopped, but that was to be sensitive to the composition of the Beatles' Come Together. So now, what does it look like if we combine using three limbs? One hand, two hands, and my leg right here. That's kind of off camera. But that's why I have Mr. Villanueva with hair, to demonstrate the legs in a situation where I cannot.
Now that we've learned to use our right foot, right hand, and left hand, we're gonna try combining all three parts to create our basic drum beat level one. So we noticed how with our shoulder on our right hand, we tap on one, two, three, four. With our right foot, we go one, two, three, four. One, two, three. Four. And with our left hand, we go one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now the goal is to combine everything. So on beat one, we use our right foot and right hand. And on beat two, we use our both of our heads. On beat three, we use right foot and right hand. And on beat four, we use both of our hands. This is our pattern, like this. Foot in hand, two hands. 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 Can you try that with me, with the metronome?
One, two, three, four.
Let's try it. One, two, beat with me. Foot in hand, two hands. 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 Foot in hand, two hands.
Cool, cool. So now, let's apply that to the realm of music. Something a little bit more appropriate for the upcoming month of October. Let's try it. Stretch it out first. I know you guys have had a long day so far, so just sneak in a quick stretch in. Here we go. snare, kick, snare, foot, hand, foot. Notice how, as I do the foot and hand, my shoulder is tapping at the same time. Da, da, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, and then elevate. One and two and three and four. One and two and three and four. One and two and three and four. So now, kick, snare is on. One, three. One, three. One, three. Foot, hand, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, and four. One and two and three and four. And one and two and three and four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And pause. Very good. So I even drew the diagram right over here. If I just appear for a second, ooh, you can see how I have my foot and hand to these numbers. So on number one, we have foot and hand. On beat two, we have two hands. On three, we use our foot and hand. And on beat four, we use two hands. But if we go to the final boss level of our body percussion, take a look. Oh, wow. There's eight hands in here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Which represents what we call the offbeats in music. So instead of saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, we instead go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Whenever my students do this, they always forget that there's an and after 4. They usually stop after 4. So let's just be mindful of the fact there's a 1 and, 2 and, 3 and, 4 and. That last and is very important. Because now we can start applying this to one of my favorite musicians of all time, Stevie Wonder. Oh, hello sound. Hello, mic check, one, two. Oh, that'd be nice to be able to hear it. Hello. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Hello, hello, music friend. All right, backup plan. Backup plan. We're going to move forward, actually. So, it's unfortunate we can see Steven, but it's okay. But here are some other ways that we can apply what we are doing in terms of music. So, if you're watching this from a desk or a table or a flat surface, you can also, in addition to using your body, you can also use random objects. So, on my left over here, or from your left, excuse me. There's a various amount of objects. I have a pointer, which I'm not going to use because I don't want to break it. We have a roll of tape. We have an empty Anaheim Elementary bottle. We have my personal water bottle, which is filled with water, and that's going to actually matter. We also have a marker in here. We also have a pen, a Captain America mug, and hands, these two hands right here, which will be the foundations of what we do over here. So check it out. So here's some things we can do. I'm gonna bring this a little bit closer to me so that the smaller camera can see it. All right, so check this out. So I have my hands on my table. So you can do things like this, you know. So right now I'm using flat hands, but you can also put your hands into a fist, like a, you know, cookie dough shape, and you can also do this. Ah. So you can go closed fist, open palm, close, open. So you can do that as well, or you can start incorporating. So, and you can see that, like, as you use a pen, you get different sounds. Because this is an empty bottle, notice how it makes a higher sound. Whereas my bottle, one, it's bigger, and two, it has water inside. By the way, drink your water. It is very important. This is your public service announcement to drink some water. It is really hot out there. You want to stay moisturized. This is your PSA to drink water. Anyways, you'll notice how you get a lower sound with a relatively fuller case. And then you have an empty Captain America mug, which, while it is empty, the Captain America mug is made out of thicker material, so you get a lower sound in comparison to the aluminum can right over here. So you could even just take a moment to explore these different sounds. And of course, you can always hit the table itself. And also hitting the pen and the marker together. Or you can just look like this. So, for those of you who know Maldita Vecindad, that is the clave groove from the song Kumbala. But I also have these tracks over here on this side of the screen. And notice I put three tracks in the center. And let's actually apply our tabletop drum set into a hip-hop groove, okay? So, again, we listen to the music. And you can do... And this is your time to play and explore. You don't have to strictly follow the beat. So for our younger friends at home, you can just, you know, start just hitting things and see what sounds come out in the context of music. But for those of us, so notice how I'm keeping the steady beat on the Captain America mug. And then you can, again, the cool thing about hip-hop beats is because these are electronically made, they typically have a really steady beat and something easy to follow. So you have your foundation in the beat of this groove, and then you can start playing on top. Yeah. Now, if you're feeling very confident in yourself, you can also play a track. You can type in, like, you know, for example, funk drumless track on YouTube, and you can get something like this, where you create your own drum beat on top, like this. So first, feel the music. So especially since there's that metronome click, you follow that. And as you can see, I started getting pretty comfortable with my tools that I have To the point where I started using my water bottle as one of my beat makers. Granted, when you're playing with tools at home, you want to be careful about not breaking anything, especially if it doesn't belong to you. So, you know, go ahead and hit things, but, you know, obviously don't get too excited and all of a sudden, oh no, Captain America is broken. We don't want that to happen at home. Plus, that'll be a big mess to clean up. We don't want to do that. Let's do one more. One more example of how we can apply this. This one will be a little bit shorter. Again, you want to make sure that you can feel the groove first. Something that I haven't mentioned yet is that you can also use a mouth like this. Boots, cats, boots, and cats. So if you want to try something called a vocal percussion or the slang of it being beatbox, you can try saying, check this out. Boots and cats and boots and cats. Boots, cats, boots, cats. Boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats. And then you take out the vowels and you get this result. Something back for a second, you can even improvise on this as well. So lots of what we call improvisation in music, because I'm a big believer in creating and improvisations, just how as we combine words and letters to form sentences, we can do the same thing in music. And as you've seen me do throughout this presentation, I've been improvising using thing objects, body parts, mouth things, and I even teased a little bit of improvisation using my melodica. But now, as we approach the tail end of our presentation, we have something in music called the solfege system, where we are introduced to this concept of do, re, mi. And the reason why we study do, re, mi is so that we can study intervals. So like, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Do, ti, la, sol, fa. Fa, mi, re, do. I caught myself saying fa wrong, but it's okay. It's okay. By the way, making mistakes in music, making mistakes in life is okay. As long as you find a way to adapt and learn from your mistakes, then making mistakes is a-okay. All right? And of course, as long as that mistake doesn't harm anybody, but that's a whole other subject matter. But yeah, so the reason why we go over the solfege in the beginning, I introduced you to this concept, is because there's this thing on Chrome, Google Chrome, called SongMaker, and they created a program where you can create your own melodies and rhythms and harmonies based off the color system established here. So if I go away for a second, you can see that do is re. Like, so I'll even play it on my melodica so you can hear it. So here's do. Here's re. Mi. fa, sol, la, ti, do. So it follows that system right over there. And then if I can read your turn, hello, I'm back. So check it out. And I'm gonna disappear for a second. Ha! Nailed it. Okay, so anyway, so we go to our red, do, si. And we have re, d, mi, yellow, e, lime green or light green, f, darker green, g, violet, a, or purple, b, t, pink, and back to do, c. So let's kind of see what we can do in the context of Chrome Music Lab Songmaker. Here I am, the songmaker. Well, actually, let me just refresh the page real quick. And you see a rainbow-colored thing. Here we go. Cool. So reflecting back on our drum thing real quick, so you can create little drum sounds over here. And these circles and triangles, the circle represents the kick, and the triangle represents the snare. So check this out. If I just play as is, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare, kick, snare. Can we make the Chrome Music Lab a little louder for the audience at home? It's a little soft on my end. But now, check this out. So here we have our color system that I was alluding to earlier. Wow, look at that. Really pretty rainbow colors. Oopsies. Oops, we don't want to do that. So check this out. If I slow it down a bit, you can do this too. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, sol, do, re, mi, fa, sol. But for those of you at home, more than likely, when you open up Songmaker for the first time, you're going to more than likely do stuff like this. Look at me, it's a happy face and a heart. Well, you know, kind of a, let's do that again. Let's create a circle of sorts, and let's do a check mark. Let's see what happens if we play with these settings. Even when you do something a little bit more loose, like, you know, just drawing smiley faces and circles and shapes, you can get some surprising amount of music in Songmaker, mainly because of the fact that the Songmaker in its default settings uses the Do Re Mi system, which is basically in major. So you can play a lot of songs in major, and a lot of popular music is in major. So for example, if we think about something, if I go onto YouTube, for example, and type in, let me think. What is a popular song? Let's go with Don't Stop Believing, Songmaker, and see what other folks have done with that. Oh, no, it's not. Somebody has not done this yet? Oh, nope, not yet anyways. So we can't do that one. Let's think, how about Uptown Funk. Oh, nope, nobody has done that either. Wow, that's kind of surprising. How about, let me think. Oh, He's a Pirate. Ah, there we are. Finally, somebody did it. Check it out. Oh, no, where'd it go? Sadness and despair. It's okay, we adapt. So let's check out. So that's actually really possible too. But let's start simple. So I have this cool drum beat over here. Let's add some spice to this drum beat. So I'm gonna add some little bits of syncopation by adding some extra kick sounds, and let's see what I can do with that. So we have a cool drum beat established, but now let's think of a simple melody that would be more common at the elementary level. Oh, how about hot cross buns, like this? Hot cross buns, hot cross buns, one a penny, two a penny, hot, oopsies, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Hot cross buns. Oh, but hang on, I made a mistake. I didn't account for rest, because rests are important, like as we saw in the Meghan Trainor song. So we go hot cross buns. So we go right here. One a penny, two a penny, hot, hot cross buns. By the way, I don't know if you can see it from your screens at home, but you'll notice that there are sections of Chrome Music Lab Songmaker that are white and grayed out. Each of these sections represents a bar in music, and each of these darker lines represents a beat. So here's beat one, beat two, beat three, and notice I have beat four. There's nothing on beat four in terms of the colors, but instead there's a drum beat there. And on beat, and then here is beat one of the second measure, beat two, beat three, and nothing over there. And then here's beat three. There's a whole bunch of things happening on measure three. And then on beat four is a repetition of the first measure. Check this out. One a penny, two a penny, hot cross buns. Yeah, it's pretty cool, right? But now let's get spicy with it. Let's create some chords under. So, from my own music theory knowledge, I know that C is red, yellow is E, and G is dark green, which is basically the C major chord or C triad or the one chord in this music. So we got a C major chord starting over here. On beat two, I think I want to include the five chord or a G chord. So I'm gonna put a D, a G, and a B. Okay, because those are the notes of a G chord. And then I want to go back and place another C chord over here, because 1-5-1 chord resolution. And because this bar repeats, let's copy that. Yes, and then we're gonna also put the C major chord here. Because this is red, I want to make this a C major chord. And I wanna do it for all the things, all the rhythms. And then we're on D, so let's make this a five chord G major using D over here, G over here, and B over here. So we have the chords over here, and last but not least, let's end it off as we began. Notice how the G is very active in all the parts over here. So you can do all this too. And check this out. Ah, ta-da! We have Chrome Music Lab Songmaker Hot Cross Buns. Hey, but what if I just wanted to do just the accompaniment? So I would just delete the melody up on top. And we'll do this in a number of different ways. So I'll slow it down a little bit so we can make this more manageable. Check this out. Hot cross buns, hot cross buns. One a penny, two a penny, hot cross buns. Mi, re, do, mi, re, do. Do, 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 re, 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 mi, re, do. As you can see, you can even improvise on top of it if you have a melodica, a guitar, ukulele, flute, recorder, your voice. You can, do just a whole bunch of things like that. Oh, and speaking of using your voice, you can even get even cheesier and do something like this. Hey, come on. Hey, this is the Hot Cross Buns rap. And I'm just making up lyrics as I go. Keep your own flow over here, feeling the groove, and we feel the groove with the song maker, and we just speak on top with a good feeling flow. Hey. So you can do stuff like that as well. So there's lots of possibilities in terms of the Crow Music Lab Songmaker. And if you want to expand upon the limitations of Songmaker, so here's some ways to manipulate it. You can enhance or decrease the length. Right now it's set to 4 bars. So we can do 3 bars or 2 bars or 1 bar. So, but what if I want to go even longer? Oh, I could do eight bars. We can do 4 beats per bar, which is fairly standard in common music. But I want to experiment with three bars split into 2 beats, so eighth notes. And then let's make, so we have major, pentatonic, and chromatic. Let's experiment with chromatic, because when you go into the chromatic mode, that allows you full possibilities of a lot of music out there, especially since nowadays, modern music started to incorporate chromatics such as blues notes and more dissonant things. So it's pretty cool that modern music is starting to expand its horizons. So let's check it out. So now it's in 3, it's gonna sound a little bit different from what we did. Check it out. So notice how it kind of crushed it. So now let's kind of just start over and kind of see what we can create with this. So now that the song is in 3, I think earlier I was playing a song called The Sleeping Beauty Waltz by Tchaikovsky. So let's recreate the melody real quick, and I think this will be the last thing that we'll do before we end the stream for today. So let's check it out over here. So we have, that's C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F. So I wanted to go to F. So, because I know that when I play it on the melodica, it starts off like this. So, it goes F, E, F. So, that F is held for 3 beats, so that takes an entire bar. F, E. In Crow Music Lab Songmaker, there's currently not a way to sustain the note, so we'll just do the initial attack. F, E, F. So, F, E. So, boom, ka, ka, boom. So, a traditional waltz groove kind of goes something like this. Boom, cat, cat, and then boom, cat, cat. All right, let's hear it first. Boom, cat, cat, boom. Yeah, okay. So let's hear it a little bit faster, like this. Okay, so do 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 boom 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 cat do, tss, tss, boom tss. So we can do this too, where we go boom tss, tss, boom tss, tss. So it's now more accurate to the drum groove right here. Boom. And now, boom, da, da, 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 boom, da, da. So that's a more typical waltz drum beat at the bottom. F, E, F, do, 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 do. So now, on the third beat of the third measure, so we have a D now. Ba, da, da. Da, da. Let's slow it down a little bit so we can hear. Bum, boo, do, 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 do. Oops, that's a D sharp. That's an E. to an F. Nope. And an E. Nope, that's not an E. Bum, 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 bum. So we have a G on the next bar, or next beat. There you go. Dum, bum, and then A. That's a A sharp. A, there you go. Dum, dum. And an F sharp, which is in between, right here. Yeesh. And then, dum. Yeah, so let's just check it out right here. What we got so far. Yeah, so again, so basic Crow Music Lab song things. But if you want the ultimate easy song, sorry, last one for sure. Crow Music Lab song maker. So if you want the ultimate easy song, here's something that you can do. Check it out. So we got yellow, do, 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 and then, of course, you want to add in, you know, a really cool drum beat to it, and we'll let that one go. Oopsies. So check this out. Mi, fa, mi, fa, dum, 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 mi, fa, mi, fa, mi, fa, mi, fa. So some of you guys might recognize that as the introduction to the Baby Shark song, but those of you that know that are a little bit older might know that as the theme song to Jaws by filmed by Spielberg, but composed by John Williams. But what most people actually don't know is that John Williams himself stole the Jaws theme from Dvorak, and specifically the New World Symphony, fourth movement. And I will show you that as the last thing that we do. Here's Gustavo Dudamel doing the thing. I'll go over a second. And there you go. That's your little piece of music history trivia for the day. Yes. So, thank you so much for tuning in to the AESD at Home music stream. Once again, my name is Mr. Villanueva from Orange Grove Elementary School. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or simply want to say hello, you can email me at evillanueva@aesd.org. Or simply evillanueva@aesd.org. So, Anaheim Elementary will be taking a break from the streaming life and will return at the end of October. So, once again, thank you guys for coming on in, and we'll see you next time at the Anaheim Elementary Home Stream at Home.